morning, everybody, and welcome to Glitchcraft. Yes, my unnamed, untitled Minecraft series has spawned something. It has spawned an actual server. We have, so far on here, two other people. We have Flame Magby. You might remember him from CommuniCraft days. And we got a new guy, at least new to me anyways, Zogog. He's a YouTuber with approximately 500 subs, somewhere around there. I will link to his channel in the description. Now, the reason it's called Glitchcraft, and hopefully I'm not stealing that name from somebody else. I'm not stealing the name from somebody else. I came up with it because we're going to be abusing glitches. But hopefully somebody else doesn't have that name, and I'm not going to have to rename the server. I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Anyways, yes, the reason that it's called Glitchcraft is because this is going to be a respawning of Quest for Creative kind of ish with a new mod pack. So it's the Tekkit Classic mod pack. It's the one I've been using. And yeah, so it's multiplayer, but it's multiplayer Quest for Creative at this point. So yeah. The reason I'm not actually doing anything, which is really unusual for me, is because the server is already living up to its name, and it's not a glitch on the server side, it's doing exactly what it should be doing. It's a glitch on my side, on my part. You'll notice up in the map, up on the mini-map up there, it looks really freaking weird. Well, there's a reason for that, and that reason is... Oh, it's nighttime. That! I was, you know, gathering up resources the other day. And, you know, planting rubber trees, using bone meal, cutting rubber trees down. Since the rubber trees, you just need one bone meal and they grow. They fall under the old tree rules. So I was just chopping them down, going back, chopping them down, blah, 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 blah. And then I went and I looked in my inventory and there was two sacred saplings. I didn't know. I had no idea whatsoever. I was told it was just a big rubber tree. That's all I was told. It wasn't emphasized or anything like that. I was just told it was a big rubber tree. Well, I planted the sacred sapling. I hit it with bone meal. Nothing happened. I hit it with bone meal again. Nothing happened. Hit it with bone meal again. Nothing happened. I wasn't losing bone meal. It wasn't making the pretty sparklies or anything like that. So I figured it glitched. So I went back inside, tried to do something. I think I was using the furnace, trying to use the furnace for something else, and it still wasn't working. Nothing was happening. And I'm like, okay, so something glitched on the server. It's lagging or something. So I'll give it a few minutes and see if it settles down. Well, about 30 seconds later, I took damage. I was in my little cave there, took damage, random damage, and... I'm like, okay, well, that's weird. And I looked outside, and there was this tree slowly spawning in. And it was slowly spawning in because the chunks were loading. So it was slowly loading in. And it loaded up and up and up, and then it started loading out and out and out. And I'm like, holy fuck, what did I just do? I'm like, okay, what the hell do I do? So I grabbed the axe. I grabbed my axe just to see what would happen, and as we found out, if you use the axe on the bottom of a tree, it chops down the entire tree. Well, I swung at this tree, and it crashed the server. Everything froze, the game completely froze up, the server crashed, everything just kind of died all at once. So I shut down the server for a day because, I mean, it was lagging to shit. You'll notice it as I'm looking around. You'll notice that the leaves are causing severe lag, causing severe problems. And I like how I can see the moon through the clouds, but when the clouds go away, the leaves are in the way. That's a weird-ass glitch right there. I guess Mojang never really planned on there being trees up that big and that high. Let's go to sleep. Let's not jump on the bed and just go to sleep. So, yeah, so I shut down the server because it was lagging out pretty bad. And I... The next day, I got a hold of Flame and Zog and told them what happened. I fired up the server to show Flame. I didn't tell him what it was right away. I've just fired up the server to show him. He comes in, he's like, holy shit. I'm like, yeah, and that's when it still had its trunk. The trunk was roundish, and it was like 10 blocks wide. It was crazy. It explains why I took damage. It was suffocation damage, and the server was just catching up to it. It's a bit insane. And then Zog pops in. He didn't want to get rid of the server. I wanted to reset the server. I did. What I would have done is actually restored from a backup. But MC, my admin's not backing up my server. I told it to back up automatically. It's not backing up automatically, and I don't know why. I'm not 100% sure why. Anyways, there was a licensing issue that I had to deal with. And I got that resolved, but I haven't rebooted the server yet, so I don't know if that actually resolves my backup issues. Like, I don't know if it wasn't backing up because of the license or anything. So, yeah, interesting stuff going on. So I couldn't restore from a backup, and Zog didn't want to get rid of the server, so thinking quickly, go away, he built that harvester up there and plunked down one of his energy cells. He got further ahead of me very quickly in the game. He's really good at this modded Minecraft stuff, and I am very out of experience. Out of practice is the phrase that I should have said. So he built that thing, and then let it go, and it started chopping down the tree. And that was a little over 24 hours ago. It was probably more about 26, 28 hours ago. And it's gotten that far. All of these chests in here that I put in here. Rubber wood and raw rubber. All of them. Every single last one of these chests. Completely full. It is crazy. We have so much wood. It's just insane. The turtles are sitting up here, are running a program that I made called Suck Refuel, and basically what it does is they suck up everything that's in front of them, because this hopper is completely full, the chest underneath is completely full, but it sucks up whatever's in front of them and then tries to use it as fuel. Well, I found out late yesterday, that the rubber that drops from the rubber trees can be used as fuel. So these guys have kind of been going at it for a couple hours now. And, well, actually this one's been going at it for about 24 hours at this point. Long ass goddamn time. And that's Flame's turtle there. Hi, gold zombie dude. Even the zombies are lagging out because of this. I was just basically hanging around here and just pretending to be a chunk loader for a while. But I finally made a chunk loader. I have one of my turtles down underground mining out, and once I got enough diamond, I made a chunk loader. And what's hilarious is right now it's set to a 10 chunk radius, which as you can see out there with the lasers active, it's right on the chunk loading border. So this is how many chunks out I can see, which fits because the server is set to 10 chunks. However, if we bounce over here one more chunk, come on, load in. Oh, it is loading more chunks. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so we can see it right there. There are leaves outside of that radius that haven't unloaded for me yet because I was in there. And they're loading in because I've walked this way. But yeah, so there are leaves further out. I think the wood ends about there-ish, I think. I'm not sure. I don't think it extends further. I think that's all leaves. Of course, that's going to be a huge, huge problem because of... oh, damn it, my sword broke. Oh, I got a bow. Use the bow. It's got punch. I got diamonds. I made an enchanting table. And I made that chunk loader. And my turtle's still down there mining away. I don't think it's going to find any more diamonds, though, but whatever. So, yeah, I don't know how well this is going to turn out. I'm probably going to have to do some interestings to make the leaves go away. As you can see, there are chunks of the leaves that are already gone. And that's because we tried to make them disappear already. And it didn't work. Basically what happened, I followed a few instructions I found on the internet. Yeah, there was a wise idea, but hey, it didn't kill the server at least. And I changed the ID for those leaves. But when we tried to log in, it just errored out saying incorrect, you know, ID, block ID or something like that. When I logged back in, some of the leaves were gone, but most of them stuck around. So I'm not 100% sure what that's going to mean in the future. Not sure at all. But I figured while I was basically just sitting around watching this thing go at it, I'd give you guys an introduction to the Glitchcraft server. And so far, what we have done... Hang on, killing zombies. So many zombies around here. It looks like it's bright as day out here. It does. But that's because of all the torches. See, the zombies aren't burning. And it's just, it looks weird, because you walk out and it looks like it's day. But it's totally not. Like, right over there is pitch black, and that's not a lighting glitch. It's just pitch black over there. We haven't put torches down. And there are just so many zombies that spawn, and they come in from everywhere, basically. From, what, 35 blocks out or something like that? It's crazy. But they just keep coming. Gets me a hell of a lot of zombie flesh, which if you cook it in a redstone, or in a, what are these things called? Come here. Yeah, a redstone furnace. If you cook it in a redstone furnace, you get leather. So, I've been gathering up zombie flesh because, you know, leather's useful to make books and stuff like that. And we have Mistcraft, so books are going to be useful in the future. Whew. It's definitely been an interesting start for us. But, so I will show you what I have set up here. This little hunk of dirt right here with a chest in front of it. There's a whole bunch of egg or chickens in there, so I've got an egg generator here. This is just a little clock that I made up with a bunch of the liquid crafters. So we take our cobblestone and turn them into compressed cobblestone, and they go down here, and they turn into double compressed cobblestone, and they go down here and turn into triple compressed cobblestone, and we end up with triple compressed cobblestone. I just have to put a whole shit ton of cobblestone in there, and it takes care of it. There is a redstone timer back there from Project Bread that's running all of this. Because the liquicrafters have to have a redstone signal, a redstone pulse, before they'll do their thing. Yeah, so, there we go. So, yeah, there's that. Over here... So watch out for all these freaking zombies. We have two steam dynamos. Underneath them are aqueous accumulators. And they're just, you know, the dynamos are just sitting on top of the aqueous accumulators because I can't, I don't have the pipage yet. I can now, but yeah, the aqueous accumulators, basically they suck up water from the infinite blocks around them and push them up into the steam dynamo, and that gets us our water. And then in this chest, I just have a whole bunch of charcoal that gets pumped into these, the item hoppers. The item hoppers get turned off by that lever. Well, both of them do. That way I can turn off the steam dynamos because they will keep running. Even if you don't want them to. Mildly annoying, but it's a thing. Again, more zombies. They come out of the freaking woodwork, and every now and then I have a creeper to deal with. Oh, it's annoying as shit. Whoop. But that's where I get power, and that's how I'm running the harvester up there. Yeah, you're still running. I have to check on it every now and then, because if you're far enough away from it, the entities won't spawn, so you can't see the entities, but it's still doing its thing. Oh, holy crap. That little bit right there, that open area right there, is not, repeat, not the top of this thing. It extends probably about another 50 blocks up from that. It goes to build height, which is like 250. It is just absolutely ridiculous how big that fucking tree is. I don't know why anybody would program that in. It's evil. I don't know, man. Let's go to sleep real quick. Another fucking zombie head. I have so many zombie heads. It's kind of insane. Boing. Okay. So what else do I got going right now? Cactus farm here. Which basically... That way I have all my cacti. I will be making an actual automated cactus farm eventually. It's not hard to do. At least, in theory, it's not hard to do. I've never done it before, so I'm not sure. But I'm gonna try. I'm sure as hell gonna try. And then one last thing I have. In here, I get a whole bunch of cooked chicken feathers. And that's because underneath this block here, if we dig the whole way down, we follow that pipe the whole way down. Well, way underground, I have another one of those chicken cooker things going. Which we all know how to build at this point. It's been done twice in this, or in, on my channel. Damn zombies. They're so annoying. There's so bloody many of them. But let's take a look around. And again, like I said, this is just an introductory video. We're not going to be doing too terribly much. That is a lighting glitch. Doop, there we go. We are on the ocean. So we have oceanfront property here. That's still crazy. Yeah, we have oceanfront property here, so I'm thinking I'm going to make a dock out there, put a boat out there, attached to the dock, and then set the spawn out there so it's like you're coming off of the boat when you join the server. I think that would be a cool idea. So let's take a look around. What is... I wonder if this thing is chopping down trees in the area as it spreads out. Hey, I got a hat. As it spreads out like it is, like, that's not where it's stopping. It keeps digging out those sides. It's doing it a very weird way, but it is digging out the sides as well. So where it's harvesting is getting wider and wider. And I wonder if it's doing that for stuff at its level as well. So as it continues, it will take out anything high enough. Which doesn't look like it's going to be much of anything anyways, because it's already pretty high. Freaking zombies, holy crap. And the damn thing extends for like 18 chunks in every direction. So yeah, I have a general idea of how wide I would need to make the chunk loader. But I don't want to make the chunk loader that wide. Ooh, that's a problem. But yeah, I don't want to make the chunk loader that wide because I am worried about memory. I mean, part of the idea of this server is to see how much this server can handle. it's perpetual night because of this fucking tree. Oh. There's clay over there, there's clay over there. You can see pretty good underwater in shadow like this. Huh. There's clay everywhere around here. Yeah, let's just explore around a little bit. There's a jungle. Holy shit. I think... Ooh. Well, there's the edge of the woods right there. Is that wood or are the leaves? That looks like a chunk loading error right there. I might not be able to progress too much further. I might not be able to progress too much further anyways. I'm gonna die. Oh my god, that's a lot of creepers. Holy crap. Go away, go away, go away. Oh, wow. I quite obviously don't head out of my little hole all that often for understandable reasons. All right, let's see if I want to explore. I want to see the edge, and I haven't seen the edge yet. So I want to see what's going on here. There's also another thing I want to show because it's another interesting little problem that we're going to have to deal with on this server. Yeah, it already came up. Holy crap. We have so many things we have to worry about on this server. Zog mentioned something about creating a mod pack for us. I can imagine that'll take some time because you got to do that right. And apparently he's got experience doing that, so... Hey. Well, there's the edge. That is creepy. And no, I am right where the chunk loading error would be if there was one, so it doesn't look like there is a chunk loading error. It just looks like that's maybe where the leaves disappeared when I changed the, ID, maybe, perhaps? But holy crap, look how far out that goes! That's wood up there. That's stuff the harvester would have to touch. Ugh. Christ. More clay. I'm keeping an eye on clay because I'm going to need an ass load of it. I plan on... I'm going to be working on the spawn village. I'm in the sun, for once. And this chicken's like, yes, sun. it's been a while in this game since I've been in direct sunlight. Whew. Like I said, fun times. I think I actually need to go that way. I'm probably already further out than I should be for what I want to show. But I wanted to see the outskirts of this damn tree. Again, I am very curious as to why somebody would program this. It's seriously bad. Kind of, yeah, not good. Not healthy. I can only imagine what this tree would have done to my previous server. The server I used to be running, the Minecraft. Yeah, I should probably specify what I'm talking about here. The previous hardware that I was running the previous server on, I can only imagine what this tree would have done to it. Because that server was SATA 2. And it was an Ivy Bridge? Right? Or no. Crap. Like, right now, we're on Haswell for the processors. Then I think before that was Ivy, and then before that was something else that I can't remember the name of. And that's what my old server was running on. It was two processor versions behind. So I can only imagine basically how much that computer would have overheated and died trying to do this. Where is it? There it is. That's what I was looking for. I think that's what I was looking for. About to find out. Whee. All right, so we have the things here. So these are the dimensional doors that I went through in one of the previous untitled episodes that were creepy as crap, and I hate them. That's a wooden door. That means somebody came back through that, I think, maybe. I'm not sure. There is another one around here, which is actually probably there. Yeah, Flame has been exploring the dimensional doors. I haven't. I don't go through them. If I can ever find it, I'll show you guys. Oh, baby zombies don't burst into flames, do they? We really don't want to hurt the children. Did I kill my sword already? Holy crap, that was an iron sword. Oh, and I'm out of food. And I'm probably going to die, and this sucks. Running, 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 running. You can't outrun these bastards either. This is a problem. But if I hop through the jungle... Oh, oh, damn lag. Come on. There we go. Okay. I should be relatively safe up here. Whew. That could have been a problem. I've really got to start keeping an eye on my hunger. Come on, come on, come on. There we go. Okay. Anyway, so back to what I was doing, trying to do anyways. Yeah, I think it's this way. That is a lot of crap that I'm going to have to deal with, too, just to get there. Is that... this guy? It might be this guy. I don't think it's this guy. I think we are... no, we're in the wrong place. Crap! I forget where it is. Alright, may as well just tell ya. There is a... I don't know, thing. I don't know what it's called. But basically, it's from dimensional doors. And if you use the dimensional doors too much, it will eat your world. It will degrade your world, and it will eat your world. So blocks will start disappearing. There'll be this black smoke kind of stuff everywhere. And it's just bad, and we have it. It's that way. And it's eating our world. We've got to fix it. There is a way to fix it. I don't know how. I'm apparently going to have to be the one to look into it. Because even though Flame's the one been using the doors, he's not going to fix it. So I've apparently got to fix it. Whew. All right, so that was the grand tour of the start. The interesting start of the Glitchcraft server. Yes, and I can see the stars through the clouds. Even though behind the clouds, there's nothing but wood. Yeah. So, interesting stuff. If very, very annoying. So, I think I'm going to end the episode here. Because, well, I'm not going to do anything more. I'm mostly just keeping an eye on my turtle. That's mining downstairs, cleaning out the cobblestone and such like that. And that's about it. I'm not really doing anything else right now. I'm waiting mostly for the tree to go away. I don't need you. I don't want you. But yeah, that's pretty much what I'm doing. I'm just waiting for the tree to go away so I can actually, you know, start doing crap again and not have to worry about the massive, massive, massive amounts of mobs coming at me. Which, again, I'm probably going to have to... Hey, you're done. What did you find? You find any more diamonds? No, you did not. Didn't expect you to, but you found more obsidian. That's good. You need obsidian to make obsidian dust, which you could combine with lead, I believe, to make hardened glass, which is used to make the item pipes and would make my life significantly easier. So that's what I'm going to do. That's why I'm excited that we actually have obsidian now. I don't have to go make it. So, yes, I am going to end the episode here, as I said before. And, yeah, I'm just basically going to be searching for supplies and such. So, you're not going to miss anything for a little while. So, I will say to you guys, as always, keep playing the game and have fun. And hopefully this looks good on YouTube because it likes darkening itself.